Diguva Ahobilam. Ahobilam is a sacred place located in the Kurnool district of Andhra Pradesh, surrounded by magnificent hills of the Eastern Ghats range. Here, the Supreme Godhead incarnated himself as Lord Narasimha Swamy to kill the demon Hiranyakashipu and to save his beloved devotee Prahlada. In Diguva, lower Ahobilam, Lakshmi Narasimha Swami is a peaceful form. The temple has exquisite stone art. The history of Ahobilam temple is sculpted in stone form. Lord Srinivasa himself is said to install the main deity here with three shrines. It is surrounded by picturesque hills of the Eastern Ghats and with several mountain hills and gorges. Temples in Lower Ahobilam, Diguva Ahobilam. Sri Karanja Narasimha, Sri Yogananda Narasimha, Sri Chatra-vatha Narasimha, Sri Paavana Narasimha, and Sri Bhargava Narasimha.
Thank you. Thank you. Sri Karanja Narasimha. The deity of Lord Narasimha is placed under the Karanja tree. Hence, the Lord is known as Karanja Narasimha. The Lord is also known as Saranga Narasimha because he holds the bow named Saranga. Lord Narasimha manifested himself as Rama with a bow in one hand and Sudarshana in the other hand. And Hanuman got convinced he was Lord Rama. There is another small deity of Hanuman in this temple. Sri Yogananda Narasimha. Lord Narasimha, after killing Hiranyakashipu, taught Prahlada a few yogic postures. In this temple, the form of the Lord is seen seated in Padmasana posture with yoga patta around his legs. It is believed that Lord Brahma visited this place once when he was disturbed mind, and by worshipping the Lord and practicing yoga, he attained peace and returned. The deity was being worshipped in a deep tunnel, but for convenience of worship, he was taken out of the tunnel and installed here. Chatra-vatha Narasimha. Here the Lord is in a unique form, having a very beautiful smile on his face. Since the Lord is worshipped under a peepal tree, surrounded by the thorny bushes, he is popular here by the name Chatra-vatha Narasimha. The left hand of the Lord is in Tala Mudra. Tala Mudra cannot be seen in any other form of the Lord in any other temple. It is said that once two Gandharvas named Haha and Hoho from the Meru mountain came here and entertained the Lord with sweet music. The Lord blessed them to become famous as great singers. Lord Indra and the demigods worshipped Chatra-vatha Narasimha here and requested him to kill the demon king. Hence, this temple is also known as Devata Ardhana Kshetra. Paavana Narasimha. Since this temple is on the banks of the river Paavana, the Lord is known as Paavana Narasimha. Here, the Lord is in the most peaceful form amongst the nine Narasimha. The temple is situated far in the middle of the forest and the devotees have to climb several steep steps to reach the temple. The steps begin from the near the temple of Sri Ahobilam Narasimha. Devotees can also access the temple by travelling in local jeeps. However, it is not recommended as the roads are not good. It is also advised to avoid visiting after 5 p.m. because of the presence of wild animals in the forests. The last and final Sri Bhargava Narasimha. This is the place where Lord Parashurama performed penance to please Lord Narasimha. Among all forms of Lord Narasimha in Ahobilam, this form is considered to be the most aggressive form. The temple is situated on the banks of the Akshaya Tirtha, which is equally regarded as the sacred Pushkara Tirtha. Parashurama is used to bathe in this tirtha and its water was used for the worship of Lord Bhargava Narasimha. Sage Vasistata and other sages have performed penance in this place. Devotees can have a darshan of Prahlada at the feet of the lotus of the Lord.
Thank you.